Good day, CLC family. We're speaking today about how we grow. God wants you to grow. Your Heavenly Father's goal is for you to mature and develop the characteristic of Jesus Christ. Sadly, millions of Christians grow old, but they never grow up. The reason is that they never intended to grow. Spiritual growth is not automatic. It takes an intentional commitment. You must want to grow, decide to grow, make an effort to grow, and persist in growing. Discipleship, the process of becoming like Christ, always begins with a decision. Jesus called us as we respond. Come be my disciple, Jesus said to him, and Matthew stand up and follow him. When the first disciple chose to follow Jesus, they didn't understand all the implications of their decisions. They simply respond to Jesus' invitation. That's all you need to get started. Decide to become a disciple. Nothing shapes your life more than the commitments you choose to make. Your commitments can develop you or they can destroy you, but both of them will define you. Tell me what you are committed to, and I will tell you what you will become in 20 years. We become whatever we are committed to. It is at the point of commitment that most people miss God's purpose for their lives. Many are afraid to commit to anything and just drift through life. Others make half-hearted commitments to competing values, which leads to frustration. Others make a full commitment to worldly goals, such as becoming wealthy and famous, and at the end up disappointed and bitter. Every choice has eternal consequences. So you had better choose wisely, Peter warns once. Since everything around us is going to melt away, what holy, godly lives should you live? Christ-likeness is the result of making Christ-like choices and depending on His Spirit to help you fulfill those choices. Once you decide to get serious about becoming like Christ, you must begin to act in new ways. You will need to let go of the old routines, develop some new habits, and intentionally change the way you're thinking. You can be certain that the Holy Spirit will help you in these changes. The Bible said, continue to work out your salvation with fear and trembling, for it is God who work in you that will act according to His good purpose. To change your life, you must change the way you think. Behind everything you do is the thought. Every behavior is motivated by a belief, and every action is prompted by an attitude. God revealed it thousands of years before physiologists understood it. Be careful how you think. Your life is shaped by your thoughts. This is what happens when you try to change your life with willpower. You say, I'll force myself to eat less, exercise more, quit being disorganized and be late. Your willpower can produce short-term changes, but it creates certain internal stress because you haven't dealt with the root cause. The change doesn't feel natural. So eventually you give up, go off your diet, quit exercising, and then you quickly revert to your old patterns. We become whatever we committed to. There is a better and easier way. The Bible says, let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Your first step is spiritual growth, and it starts changing the way you think. Changes always start first in your mind. The way you think determines the way you feel, and the way you feel influences the way you act. Paul said, There must be a spiritual renewal in your thoughts and attitude. To be like Christ, you must develop the mind of Christ. The New Testament called this mental shift repentance, which in Greek literally means to change your mind. We are committed to think the same, or we are commanded to think the same way Christ Jesus thought. The first half of the mental shift is to stop thinking immature thoughts, which are self-centered and self-seeking. The Bible says, stop thinking like a child or like children in regards to evil, but be infant, but in your thinking, be adult. Babies by nature are completely selfish. They think only of themselves and their own needs. They are incapable of giving. They can only receive. That is immature thinking. The second half of thinking like Jesus is to start thinking maturely, which focus on others, not yourself. In his great chapter on what revealed love is, Paul concludes that thinking of others is the mark of maturity. When I was a child, I talked like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put childish away behind me. Christianity is not a religion or philosophy, but a relationship and a lifestyle. The core of that lifestyle is thinking of others as Jesus did instead of ourselves. The Bible says we should think of their good and try to help them by doing what pleases them. Even Christ didn't try to please himself. Thinking of others is the heart of Christ likeness and the best evidence of spiritual growth. This kind of thinking is unnatural, counter-cultural, rare and very difficult. Fortunately, we have help. God has given us his spirit. That's why we don't think the same way that people of this world think. May God bless you and have a wonderful week. Amen.